If you've been saving up your hard-earned cash for a bucket list trip to Alaska to see the Northern Lights, then you definitely want to maximize your chances of seeing them. In this video, we're going to cover all the details to help you plan the best time to come see the Northern Lights. Hey everyone, I'm Ron Murray with the Aurora Chasers, and in this week's edition of the Northern Lights Explain, I'm going to answer the question that you guys have asked the most lately. When is the best time to see the Northern Lights? We're going to cover the best times of year to visit to see the Northern Lights, as well as the different seasons and what makes each unique, and challenges and benefits to each season. If you stick around to the end of the video, we'll even cover specifically the best time of the evening to see the Northern Lights. And I do have a couple of questions that I'd like to ask you and get some feedback on, so I'll cover that at the end of the video as well. With this particular series, our goal is to cover a new topic or question that we've gotten about the Northern Lights over the years and discuss it and break it down for you guys. So if you're enjoying this, please do give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more of those, hit that subscribe button now and leave us a comment below telling us the questions that you might have for future topics. We're always looking for ideas. And so if there's something that you want to know about the Northern Lights that you'd like to see covered in one of these videos, go ahead and leave us a comment. We'll try to cover it. And with that, let's jump right in. The aurora is occurring above us all year long, winter, summer, spring, and fall. But Alaska is the land of the midnight sun, and so we can't see the aurora in the middle of the summer. We don't see stars, we don't see darkness, and so we can't see aurora. But basically from the end of August, August 21st essentially, until about mid-April, we can see the Northern Lights in Fairbanks because it is getting dark at that time of year. Now during Lady Aurora's time to shine, the best time to visit is in the spring or the fall, the 8-week period around either the spring or fall equinox. In fact, according to NASA, geomagnetic storms are almost twice as likely to occur in either the spring or the fall as they are in the summer or the winter months. That's according to the historical data. So why around the equinoxes? According to Dr. Tony Phillips, it's a matter of geometry. As the Earth goes around in its orbit, Earth's magnetic poles wobble back and forth. He does clarify, the poles don't actually wobble back and forth, but the combination of Earth's 23-degree polar tilt plus the orbital motion makes the poles seem to wobble from a solar point of view. Around the time of the equinox, Earth's magnetic field is best oriented for connecting up with the sun, opening the door for solar wind energy to flow in and spark the Northern Lights. And so this is why we schedule our tours in the spring and the fall. We want to maximize your guys' opportunity to see the Northern Lights, and so we only schedule tours at the time when you have the best odds. So again, in the fall and the spring around either equinox. Now there are some key differences between the spring and the fall season, and you'll want to be aware of those when you're trying to plan the best time for you. And Marquette and I actually differ on our preferences here. So let us know in the comments below if you're Team Marquette or if you're Team Ron. I personally prefer the fall season. I love the warmer temperatures. I used to love the cold, not so much anymore. So I do enjoy those warm temperatures. And the added bonus of the warm temperatures is that we have open water. So we can actually go to lakes and ponds and streams, and we can get near the water surface and photograph those auroras with the reflections or mirrored auroras in the image. Really nice foreground opportunities, and we can get double the bang for our buck because we're basically getting twice the amount of aurora. Fall also happens to provide the best views of the Milky Way Alaska gets over the entire year. And so if we're really lucky, on occasion in the fall, we can sometimes shoot both features together. So we got a shot of the aurora and the Milky Way in a single shot, just like Marquette's done here. And if you happen to be there at the early part of the season, say the last week of August into mid-September or so, we do have beautiful fall colors that with a little bit of moonlight light up really nice, and so you can get shots like this. Another perk of visiting in the fall is most of Alaska's summer attractions are still running at that time. So, for example, you could visit Denali National Park up until about mid-September, and it's a lot less crowded, so it's a great time to visit. So you can do all the things on the Kenai Peninsula, hit Denali National Park, and then make your way up to Fairbanks for the Northern Lights. You get the best of all Alaska has to offer, all in a short time right there. However, If you're going to visit in the fall, do be prepared to spend 5 to 7 nights chasing the aurora each night, because the weather can be a bit more temperamental. We end up with some kind of stormy weather on occasion. So to maximize your odds, you want to give yourself multiple nights just in case. If fall interests you like it does me, hashtag Team Ron in the comments below. Marquetta prefers the spring season, and that's for a couple of reasons, but primarily she just really loves those beautiful white snowy landscapes. She says everything looks really clean and nice, and it's cold and quiet and the air is still, and so she enjoys that, those nice frozen trees, things like that. It is a very different and very Alaska feel in those shots, and so it is unique and it's something kind of cool to check out. Another great perk to March, for example, is it is statistically the clearest month of the year in Fairbanks, followed closely by February. And so if you really want to increase your odds of seeing a good show, March and February are the great times to come because the skies tend to be really nice and clear. But it is much colder, so be prepared for that. But if you don't mind the extra cold, it's worth the effort because there's a lot of stuff going on in March. For example, you could do some ice fishing. You could take a sled dog ride with our friends at Serious Sled Dogs. I'll link them in the description below. Check out the World Ice Art Championships. The world's best ice carvers come from all over the world and compete in this amazing competition and build multi-block ice structures. Really cool to photograph. You can also maybe catch a dog sled ride. There's all kinds of stuff going on in the spring, so it is a cool time to come. Now, do be aware that if you do come in March, it is busy. It gets booked up quick, and so if you're planning that time of year, plan your trip early, at least several months in advance. You want to book your hotels, your airlines, your car rentals, and your tours all well in advance for that time of year. And hashtag Team Marquetta below if that's the time of year you would prefer to visit. If you'd rather avoid the crowds, October and February are great alternatives to September and March. It is a little bit colder in both of those months than their counterparts, but it is a great time to come. Temperatures in October can easily reach into the sub-zero range, and then in February, it's really not uncommon to see 40 below or colder, so be prepared for that. It is extremely cold in February. You'll need to make sure you're dressed appropriately for whatever season you visit. February, March, and October especially get colder, and so we lay that all out on our website under the FAQs section. I'll link that in the description below as well, but we do lay it out layer by layer for you so that you know exactly what to purchase, what to rent, and what to have with you so that you can actually be out enjoying those northern lights instead of being frozen or hiding in the van where it's warm. Early April can be good as well. It does tend to be a bit warmer, and the aurora activity levels are still good at that time of year, but the weather does tend to be a bit more temperamental and more cloudy skies. So if you're going to come for April, make sure you plan again extra time for that. Now I should note, you can see aurora anytime from late August until mid-April, anytime that it's dark in Alaska. But it's better to kind of, if you have the option, plan around those equinoxes. November and December tend to be kind of temperamental weather-wise. It gets really cloudy and snowy that time of year, and then January is just brutally cold. And as we mentioned before, your best odds are really around the equinoxes. You actually double your chances if you're around the fall and spring season as opposed to the dead of winter. So if you have the luxury of planning that trip out, make sure that it's around fall or spring. If not, and you're coming in December because it's a Christmas trip or something like that, you still have a chance of seeing the Northern Lights. It's just that you double those odds if you come in spring or fall. Now, I promised I'd tell you guys the best time of night, and the best time of night to be out there once you're in Fairbanks is between 10 p.m. and 2 a.m. That's typically when the aurora is at its strongest. We'll go into the details behind why that happens in a future video, so make sure you hit that subscribe button, but that's really your key times. 11 to 3 o'clock if you're daylight savings time. Keep in mind, Lady Aurora does not care about our arbitrary sense of time, and so we shift our tour times, and so should you. You should be out there from 11 to 3 if it's daylight savings time. And for those of you who have stuck around this long, thank you guys so much for watching the entire video. I really appreciate it. I do have a couple of questions and I'd love to get your feedback. I've really been enjoying producing this type of content. This is kind of where my heart lies, is in teaching. And I've been studying the Northern Lights alongside Marquetta for over a decade now. And one of my favorite things about what we do as a business, which is take people out to see the Northern Lights, is educating them both on the photography skills and about how the aurora Aurora works. And I hope you guys are enjoying this too. If you are, let us know in the comments below. If you're just here and all you want to see is the pretty videos, let us know that too, because ultimately at the end of the day, it doesn't matter what I enjoy, it's about what you guys are enjoying. And so if you're getting something out of this and you want us to continue this, we're going to keep producing this content. If there's other things that you'd rather see, well, we want to make you guys happy and we want to focus on what you guys are enjoying. So let us know in the comments. And again, if you guys have questions for things that you'd like to see covered, we're always happy to delve into some of those topics. So let us know that stuff as well. It is a labor of love. The video about what causes the colors of the Northern Lights took over 100 hours, for example. So if that's a good place to put our efforts, let us know. If it's not, let us know that too. Guys, thanks so much for watching this all the way through. I always appreciate it. Next week, we'll be covering some of the common myths about the Northern Lights that have been perpetuated over time. So make sure you check out that video as well. Guys, really, thank you for being here. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next video.